ejection fraction just happens to be part of a cardiology aspect as well. You have ejection fractions for your gallbladder, but you also have ejection fraction is most commonly known for cardiology. It is pretty exciting. When I saw this question, I looked at it and I thought, okay, what is an ejection fraction? And first of all, I spelled it wrong. When I was thinking of it, I spelled it like injection. You give somebody an injection, but this is actually spelled with an E. And they're saying, can I code an ejection fraction of 0% as with occlusion? Well, let's talk about what it is. So by definition, ejection fraction is a measurement of the percentage of blood leaving your heart each time it contracts. So picture your heart, and you've got the two chambers at the top, and you have the two chambers at the bottom. The two chambers at the bottom are called ventricles, all right? Now, you have a right ventricle and a left ventricle. It just so happens that the left ventricle is the one that has the most power, fills up, you know, with the most blood. So they can check both of them, but usually they start with the left ventricle. And what happens is when that contracts, it pushes out the blood. So then when it opens back up, the blood pushes into that ventricle, okay? So you have a certain capacity that ventricle, that chamber can hold. And as it contracts and, you know, pushes that blood up past the valve into the atrium, the ejection fraction is not the amount of blood that pushes, that gets out of the chamber, but some of that blood is left in the ventricle. Okay, so let's say that, you know, you're never going to get 100% of the blood to go up into the atrium. There'll be a little bit left. So they take how much went up there. Let's say 85%. So then that's how they measure that. It's not what's left in the ventricle. It's how much got pushed through. Now, there's guidelines that tell you how much is normal. So it's measured. Now, if we slide down on this a little bit more, we'll see that since the left ventricle, which is abbreviated as LV, you'll see it like that, is the main one, and that is the one that's measured, the LV ejection fraction of 55% or higher is, for the most part, considered normal. Okay, so that's what you're looking at. So 55% of the blood goes from the ventricle and whooshes through the up into the atrium, goes through that valve. Right. So if you're 50 to 55%, it might be considered borderline. But there's some studies, you know, and different physicians consider certain things. 50, 51. 50 might not be borderline for them. So slide down just a little bit more, and we're going to actually see what are the reasons for an ejection fraction to be low. It might not be what you thought. It's weakness of the heart, so they might have dilated cardiomyopathy. And again, on these terms, if you don't know what cardiomyopathy means, you need to go Google it. You need to go look it up, right? Maybe a former MI, meaning they'd had a heart attack. And just a little tidbit, in ICD-9, it was like 6 weeks out, I think, that would be considered an old MI. And ICD-10, it's only four weeks, so there's a big change there. It might be a heart valve disease, right? So as that goes through, the valve isn't working properly, so that injection of blood up into the atrium may not be the exact a good amount that it should be. And they might just have uncontrolled hypertension and may have had it for a long time. Those are all things that could give you a low ejection fraction. So how do they figure this out? What do? Well, they can do several tests. They do echocardiograms. They do cardiac catheterizations. They may do an MRI. They do CT scans, and they do a nuclear medicine scan. All of those are ways that they can tell and see how much fluid and track that's getting up, that blood that's getting up from into the atrium from the left ventricle. And they can do the right ventricle too, but usually what they do is they focus on the left ventricle because that's kind of the powerhouse of the heart. I think I've got a little bit more down here. Ah, there we go. Here is now what I wanted to say to answer the question that was given. Occlusion has to be documented. So occlusion isn't necessary. If we've got 0% ejection fraction, that doesn't necessarily mean there's an occlusion. Okay, so I would say the answer to your question is no. It has to state that it has to be documented for you to call it an occlusion, because there's several other reasons why it could be that low. And this is an image of what they're doing. There's the left ventricle. You can always tell if you're looking at the back or the front of the heart by the way the apex is looking. So if that apex, the little V part of the heart, is facing this way, we're looking at the front of the heart. If it's facing off to the other side, we're looking at the back of the heart, FYI. So there we've got the percentage of blood ejected up into the atrium, and that's the left ventricle. And right there at the last, I added normal 50 to 65. Below normal is 36 to 49. Anything below 35 is just real bad news. So what happens, it usually means they get like AFib. Okay, and so then you can treat that. But if you have a low ejection fraction, they're absolutely going to run more tests to find out what's going on, and you'll probably be either, you know, they could give you a pacemaker maybe, or but you'll result in AFib. Medication and stuff can be given, and that is most of this information I got was from the Mayo Clinic. And there's the website, mayoclinic.org/ejection-fraction/experts. Anyway, I love the Mayo Clinic. Lots of good stuff there.
Do you need more medical certification training? Go to www.cco.us. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for updates.